Hello and welcome to This Is My Architecture. Today I'm joined by Zafar from HeyJobs. Hey Zafar.
Hello David.
Zafar, can you tell us about HeyJobs?
At HeyJobs, we are aiming to be a leading platform for those looking for the right job to live a fulfilling life. Mm-hmm. With our simple search, job ad transparency, and fast application process, people can apply the jobs that matches with their expectation in shortest possible time.
Okay, with that solution, I'm sure you probably process tons of data related to those jobs you display on the platform. Can you give me a high-level overview for the solution we're going to talk about today?
Yeah. We have built a serverless data solution. Mm-hmm. Every day, we ingest 3 million records to our platform. Mm-hmm. How we do that? We are pulling the data from partners. Partners providing endpoints to us, and we are pulling the data into our platform with cron jobs that we use with Event Bridge. And then inside the Lambda, since we receive huge data, we are splitting into smaller chunks to be processed later in the platform. After that, after processing it, what we are doing, we are making it available in the talent platform for the applications, for search functionality, for filtering too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, understand. So once you ingested this data from the partner portals, I assume this is like different formats, different schemas. How do you make sure you have all the data normalized in your data platform?
Yeah. After ingesting that, what we are doing, we are putting all the smaller chunks into SQS. Mm-hmm. We are saving them, we are putting them into SQS, and we can queue up to process it later with not scaling too high. And then we are consuming these SQS messages with Lambda and normalizing them and making that the quality is high on that jobs. Also, we are enriching the data too. After that, we are storing the data inside AuroraDB.
Okay, understand. So here, each row in the database is basically corresponding to one job that's later appearing on the talent platform, right?
Yes.
Okay. I also see a machine learning component here at the bottom. Can you walk me through what that exactly does?
Sometimes we are receiving lean data from partners to enrich that data, mm-hmm, and categorize the data. We are using machine learning models that we created with SageMaker. And also we are using natural language processing in that models. And after that, we are communicating with the Lambda that we use for processing and storing enriched data inside our database.
Okay, I understand. How does the whole enrichment process here with machine learning relate to the user experience in the end of the platform?
At the end, users can search with better filters, mm-hmm, and they can filter based more granular way. We have more options for them that we enrich the data, yeah.
Okay, that's great. Okay, so you mentioned the talent platform now a few times. What exactly does it do, and how do users in the end consume all of this information we have generated here?
Yeah, users are consuming the data from the talent platform with a filtered and enriched data, mm-hmm, and then they are receiving it in a fine granular base.
Okay, and how does this data get to the talent platform?
Yeah, we are pushing a notification to SNS topic, mm-hmm, after we process and reach the data. And then SNS topic is fanning out the data into multiple SQS queues. Mm-hmm. And after that, this queue consumed by containers that we created inside Talent Platform. Mm-hmm. And they are adding the data to Talent Platform DB to make the data available for the customer users that we have.
Mm-hmm. And the users basically consume it from the web portal that is running here on this
section? Okay. Yeah, users are coming to our application, and then with a front-end application, we are connecting to ECS containers and pulling the data for the users.
Okay, got it. I really like how you use across the board serverless technologies. You use messaging patterns here, like this SNS and SQS chaining pattern here as well. Can you walk me through the evolution of how you got to where you are at the moment?
At first, we had only this part, a monolith application that, mm-hmm, is serving, ingesting, doing all the job. But it was hard to scale up and down for the load that we have. What we have done, we have built a serverless application that can scale up and down all the time. Mm-hmm. Whatever we need, we don't need to think about it if it is going to handle or not. Later on, we have realized that from few hundred thousands, we can process few millions. And then also we checked the cost and we realized that we saved up to 30% too.
Okay, that's quite impressive. And that's the beauty of serverless, right? You only pay for the resources you consume.
Yeah.
I really like that. Thanks so much for sharing that, Safa.
You're welcome.
And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.